Hi there! Need to learn how to freeze a row in Excel? Let me help. Hey, I'm Sharon from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you save time, work smarter, and improve your Microsoft Office skills. If you're new here, make sure you click that subscribe button, and any links I mention in this video, you can find linked in the description box below. So, let's look at how to freeze a row in Excel. I'll show you how to freeze the first row in a worksheet and the first column, and then I'll show you how to be more specific about where you want your rows to be frozen. For example, you might want to freeze rows 1 to 3 so that you can see them on the screen as you scroll down, and maybe columns A to C so that you can see the first three columns as you scroll across. And once I've helped you master freeze panes, to help you even more, I'll share with you a link to where you can grab our free self-assessment tool, where you can gauge your current skill level in Excel and create your own personal learning plan to help you fill in any gaps. Right, let's sort this out for you. It can be a real pain when you don't have freeze panes on, and of course you start to scroll down the screen and you lose the headings at the top of your columns. Gosh, that's just such a pain because you can't actually see. Here we've got like cost price, recommended retail price, sale price. So if I scroll down, I can't actually see which one of those represents each option. So you're not alone. Everybody has a problem with this, and it's something that when I cover it in my workshops, people go, oh my goodness, I just love this. So let's do this together. Now we're looking at row one here up the top here. We'd love to have that frozen so we can see that as we scroll down, we don't lose it. So what we'll do is we'll make our way up to the view tab, and we're going to come down to freeze panes. Look at that, it's even got a little icicle on it. So we'll just click on that little drop down menu. Now what I'll do is I'm just going to shoot right to the middle option here. We've got the freeze top row. Now, as soon as I click this on, you're going to see, or I hope you can see, there's a tiny gray line that's now being produced. It's underneath the first row. So if I start to scroll down, look at that. It actually stays on the screen, which is gold. Absolutely brilliant. And if I scroll across, you're going to see the same thing. So there you go, it's nicely locked on there. Now at any time, if you want to remove your freeze panes, it's quite easy, you just come back up here and unfreeze. So it's not defrost, it's unfreeze. So I'll just take this off, and now you'll see that we're back to where we were before. So first row, easy peasy, that's really easy to kind of get that stuck on. Where the challenge comes in is where you have got a situation where it's not the first row. So I'm just going to come over to another little worksheet that I've sorted out here for you. And what we've got here is it's not row one, it's row three. So of course I scroll down here, this has got thousands of records in it, and you'll see that again we've got that same problem where we're losing the column titles, and it's hard to see what's in each column. So in this instance, if I went up here and popped on freeze top row, of course it's going to freeze my annual sales, and that's no use to me. So I'll just go and grab unfreeze. Now this is what you're going to do. If you are wanting to freeze from a set point, you're going to select in column A underneath the row that you're wanting frozen, so directly underneath that row. Now when I come up here, what I would like you to do is click freeze panes, the top option here. Now as soon as you go on to here, can you see where the line is now? So look, as you scroll down, it's locked on. So that is how you can manage anywhere where the row is a little bit lower than row one. So I'm just going to go and take that off. So I hope that's been helpful. I'm going to take that off now. And what I want to do is I want to talk about freeze columns as well. So I'll just go and take this off. And of course, if I wanted to freeze the first column, that's easy. Of course, it's the bottom option there. And we do this when we're actually scrolling across to the right. And of course, you want to see that invoice number. So if you've got like 50 odd columns and you're losing the invoice number or anything else that's kind of useful to you, that can be a real challenge as well. You know, I see a lot of people actually just use color. They'll kind of color something. And then of course, as they're scrolling across, they can see that that's the same row that they're needing. No, you can just use freeze panes to do that. So I'm just going to take that off. So of course that top, these two options are pretty obvious. Top row, first column. I'll just go and take that off. But what if I actually wanted to have invoice, customer name, both of those showing as I scroll across. So again, we're now in a little bit of a challenge. So here's the rule. This is how you work with freeze panes. I've taught you already that if you're wanting to scroll down, of course you have to go below the row that you're actually wanting to freeze, and then up you go and you use this option here. But if we're now wanting to include, and of course I asked you to go into column A here, which made it easy because of course that means that you're just freezing the row up the top here. But if we're actually wanting to put a lock against these two columns and on the rows up here, what you can do is you can go below the row you want locked on and to the right of the columns you want locked on. So I'll just say that again. You go to the row underneath the row that you're wanting to have locked on, and you're going to the right of the two columns that you're wanting to be frozen as well or locked on. So once you've done that, then you go to here. Keep rows and columns visible while the rest of the worksheet scrolls. Now look at this, based on current selection. So it's basically saying based on the current cell that you have selected, it will freeze above and to the left of where you are. So let's go and click onto this one now, and you should now see the little gray lines. And if I scroll down, look at that. We've now got the headings on there. And as we scroll across, we've got those two columns showing. So I really hope this instruction has been helpful and you are now able to freeze your worksheet from any point that suits you. Just remember to select freeze first row or first column if you only need these visible. But if you need to freeze from a set point, select the cell below the row you want frozen and the column to the right of the columns you want frozen. Then select the top option on the freeze panes menu. Now, if you're really serious about improving your Excel skills and you'd love an idea of just what you need to know to become a more than proficient user of Excel, click the link on screen or click it in the description box below to grab your copy of our Steps to Becoming Proficient in Excel guide, a brilliant tool to use to assess your current skill level, identify gaps in your knowledge, and learn where to find the info you'll need to fill in any gaps you have identified. Now, if this has been helpful, please hit the like button and please let me know in the comments below. And if you use Excel and want to stay connected, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell because we're sharing new videos regularly. And if you know someone who would benefit from this help, please be sure to share this video with them. Hey, have a great day and thanks for watching.